I've been smoking since I was 15 years old. And I wanted to make this video in order for people that are watching to actually connect and go on this journey with me. Well, first of all, I'm going to try and elaborate what we'll be doing in a timeline. First, I'll be talking about who I am and my experiences with smoking, so you can see that I am someone that you can relate with, and not just someone that went up and looked at a scientific article or just went to Google and searched this in order to make a video for some views. Then, second of all, I'm going to talk on how I actually managed to stop smoking. Well, let's get on with this then. Guys, my name is Celso. Most of you that are watching me because of this video probably don't know me. And even if you aren't, you probably don't know me. My channel is a little bit small. And basically, guys, my story is as follows. I started smoking when I was 15. And it was the stupidest decision that I made in my life. Because at the time, I think that it was countrywide in Portugal. Everyone was really getting the education and talked about smoking and how it's bad for you and how you shouldn't do it. And until then, I was really, really, really against smoking. And I was given the opportunity to smoke a lot until when I was 15. So I could have done it, but I never did because I knew it was bad. And yeah, then some of my friends, they started smoking. And I was like, okay, I mean, it's not ideal, but they do what they want with their life, okay? And then I don't know why, but on my developing teenage brain, this thought occurred to me and it whispered, Celso, you need to live life. You can't miss out. You can't look when you're old to yourself when you were 15 and think, I didn't smoke. I should have tried it to see if it was good. Yeah, I know. Stupid. Anyway, I tried smoking because, I mean, I was around a lot of people that smoked, but not one of them actually tried to get me to smoke, quite on the contrary. But I still wanted to do it and they were like, okay, if you want to try it, who am I to tell you not to, because I also smoke. And I tried it. And at first, I just kind of bought like cigarette packs, but I split them with friends, one or two friends, and I only smoked on the weekend. I smoked like when I went out for a coffee, and I used to do it at Saturday nights and Sunday after lunch. So yeah, I only smoked around those days. And yeah, I mean, I didn't even smoke that much because I was splitting a pack with one to two people. Yeah. Yeah, guys, English is not my first language. Anyway, I was splitting my pack of cigarettes, and even then I was splitting it around 2 days. So I was smoking like max 10 cigarettes a week, max. And yeah, it stayed like that for a long while, and quite rarely, really, really not common for me, I would smoke like one or two cigarettes during the weekdays when I was in high school. So yeah, that was it for quite a while until I turned 18 and I went to college. Guys, one thing you guys need to know about me was that I was really, really, really sheltered as a kid. And I couldn't go out of the house a lot. And my first experiences around partying and socializing and girls, like for real, was at 18. Because I had a lot of freedom when I went to college. And as probably some of you are thinking already, that went terribly wrong. Because I got loose. I started smoking a lot. Because I had the freedom to do it and I never had it, I started going to every party that I possibly could manage to go, and I started drinking as a grown-up. That was like a time where I just drank, you know, unhealthily, and I have quite a lot of embarrassing stories that I never actually managed to replicate, thank God, and I never will. Because it was stupid, okay? Anyway, I started smoking a lot when I was 18, and then it's eventually tapered down. When I got my first job, which was when I was 21, 21, 22. I think it was 22 actually, yeah, 22. Anyway, I was 22 and I got my first job as a software engineer. And until then, I tapered a little bit and I didn't smoke as much, but still, I was smoking anywhere around the range of 10 cigarettes a day. And it stayed like that for a long while until my first time quitting smoking. Yeah, you heard me right. This isn't my first rodeo, okay? And yeah, I quit smoking, I think when I was 23, I did it for 8 months. And I came back to smoking again. Why did I come back to smoke again? Well, because I was at the birthday of a friend of mine once, and he was like, "Hey, bro, do you want a cigarette?" And I was like, "No, man, you know I don't smoke. It's been eight months right now, so yeah, I don't really want it." And he's like, "Yeah, I know you don't smoke, but maybe if I thought you would want to have one because it's my birthday." And I'm like, "Yeah, you know what? Cigarettes don't really have a power over me. They don't have a hold over me anymore. So yeah, let's smoke one." Yeah, didn't go out too well. I was stupid once again. Because that's how addiction comes at you. You think you're almighty and that you have power over your addiction because you haven't indulged in it for a couple of months. But oh boy, was I wrong. Because I smoked that one cigarette. And then I smoked another one cigarette like 1 week after. And then after that, I started thinking to myself, maybe, just maybe, I can smoke when I go out at the weekends. And I started doing that. But eventually, some of those cigarettes were left over from the weekends. So I had one once on my weekdays. And I just went with some of my friends when they went on a smoke break once when I was working. And as you probably know by now where I'm going with this, I started smoking the same as I first did again. And yeah, that's where I was until 35 days ago. Yeah, I stopped smoking, hopefully my last cigarette, 35 days ago. So yeah, I quit 35 days ago, 1 month ago, and I'm pretty happy with it. It's been rough, it's been hard, it will be hard. It's not as rough as the first 3 or 4 days or even the first week, but yeah, it's still not as easy as I thought it would be, because sometimes, just sometimes, I still want to smoke a cigarette. But yeah, I haven't for 35 days. And I hope that I will be able to make the video on how I stopped smoking 1 year ago. Yeah, so wish me luck, guys. Now, how did I actually do it? Well, guys, the thing is, I tried tapering down my cigarette consumption before, and just like going from 10 cigarettes to 9 cigarettes to 8 cigarettes to 7 cigarettes, you know, until I eventually quit smoking. The thing is, didn't work for me, because with each cigarette that I stopped smoking, they became more valuable and they held more meaning in my day. When I smoked 10 cigarettes, it was I smoke a cigarette and it was just one more cigarette. I had plenty during the day. But when I was down to like 3 cigarettes, I was looking forward to those 3 cigarettes, you trust me. I was looking forward and I just wanted to smoke more and more because I had only 3 cigarettes. And when something is scarce, you really, really, really want it. So it didn't work for me. It didn't work for me. I would go down to like 3 cigarettes and then I would just smoke a ton more and go like to 10 again because I couldn't handle that. So, what I did on my first time quitting and what I did 35 days ago was quitting cold turkey. Guys, in my opinion, it's the best choice. It sucks. It sucks. It sucks a lot. Imagine getting kicked in the balls 2 times by an elephant. That's how much badly it sucks, you know? But it's the best way, because it sucks a lot for a short period of time and then you're out. It then starts sucking a little bit less every day. It still sucks right now, but not nearly as much as it did before. So yeah, guys, if you want my opinion and what I think works best, just go cold turkey, bros. Anyways, if you are thinking about quitting because you are watching this video, if you are trying to quit right now, leave a comment down below. Let's get both of ourselves accountable for our choices. Me making this video is a way to make myself accountable to stop this nasty addiction. Because I am talking to you right now about this, and I just said that I want to make a video 1 year from now. Actually, 11 months from now, saying that I stopped smoking 1 year ago. And if you want to go on this journey with me, hell, with us, because we are a community, leave a comment down below stating that you will be quitting smoking right now. Not tomorrow, not the next week, not in 1 year, not when you're 30 or 40 or 50. Because trust me, if you think it is hard to stop smoking right now, in 10 years it will be 10 times harder, and in 20 years it will be 20 times harder, and in 30 years it will be 30 times harder. Because if you let this habit, this addiction, just really get a hold of your life, even one more day it will be harder tomorrow to stop, to quit smoking than it was yesterday. Trust me on this one. If you don't do it now, if you didn't do it yesterday, the next best time to quit smoking is right now. So let's do it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, go down below, leave a like and subscribe. You guys probably don't know what I do usually. I do videos about fitness. I really like fitness, and I try to do good quality content. Not there right yet, but I'm trying to get better. Anyway, if you are interested in that, subscribe. See what comes out of this channel for the next couple of days, weeks, months, or maybe years. Guys, see you next time. Peace.